Hey, welcome back. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we are going to start tightening this up a little bit. We're not going to like make it like a totally tight drawing, but I do want to take it a step further. And I'm also going to be working with titanium white, which I have right here. All right, so I'm using a little brush, and basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the sky and just work my way down. Tightening the values, and that is too bright. Let me mix some burnt sienna into here and get this going. You don't want it to get too bright right away. You want to reserve that for the final. My lamp just almost fell over there. That was interesting. Okay, so we're gonna come here and we're just gonna. And once again, we're working very loosely, just getting my lightest lights. We're not looking for perfection. We're just kind of mapping out where everything is going to go. This mountain or this hill back here a little bit. We don't want it to be finished because we want those fresh brush strokes to really be reserved for color. So now I've got a little green on my brush too. And we're just working out this first cloud here. Keep it things very loose. And what do I mean by loose? I mean not defined, not too dark. Keep the edges very soft. Sort of like a Polaroid that hasn't fully developed yet. Okay, so now that I've done that, I'm going to come back here and kind of get this mountain. And I'm using vertical strokes, not horizontal ones. Kind of another area back here that's sort of an intermediate value. I need to put some more green out here. we've got other mountains back here. I'm gonna add a little bit of white that aren't, ooh, too much white. They aren't as they're the intermediate value between the lightest mountain and then the darkest one. And there are all these little ones back here. So I'm still painting pretty loosely, but I'm looking a little bit more closely at the lines and the values. And we can start coming over here and painting this. This is that road. Very tempting to want to put white, but you must resist that temptation. I'm gonna keep it very gray for right now. This burnt sienna with the viridian really can make just a gorgeous gray. So I'm looking at the drawing, but I'm sort of drawing it and shading at the same time. So I'm looking at shapes, I'm looking at lines, and I'm looking at values. I'm really not thinking about color at all. That's going to go on our next step. So when I do this, I'm removing some of this extra paint. The paint is getting very thick. We want to paint very thinly. And I'm also just softening some of these areas out here. Some of these more extreme values. that better? So whenever I put plain white on, I know it's going to be mixing. This rocky outcrop right here got a little bit big. Notice how I'm painting with vertical. Yes, there are going to be these little horizontal lines on top, but those are going to be in blue and those are going to come later. And that's how you get the depth of the... the depth of the water there. And of course... this is the shadow here, which is right up next to that mountain. It's almost the exact same value, but there is that little highlight there. And so you know that this is where the water will end, right there. I've way overstated that. Come in here and remove some of it. So all of this down here is shadow. And this is shadow here too. We know that this is going to be the land because of that little highlight. Well, on the color change, but. There's a very dark shadow here. This is just viridian plus brown. Little touches. I may be getting a little bit into too much detail here. It's very tempting to want to get into detail. I'm just gonna say it. Tempting. Anytime you paint, find yourself kind of like, there's a certain brushstroke I call a kill brush stroke. And that's just where, you know, everything's just very flat and it's like wall painting. And when you see me punching and doing like these little things, I'm trying to put like a little bit of, well, vibration. The beautiful painting is alive. You know, you want it to have, you want it to dance. That's what's so, Yeah, there can be a very beautiful brush stroke that's, like a sweep, but that's not how you, that's not what this painting is about here. It's got lots of interesting little bits of texture. And you create texture by these dots and how much paint you have on your brush and how hard you're pushing. And come here and move this down here. And then if you want to paint something smooth, like the glassy surface of a body of water, it will look smooth because everything else is rough, right? Here we have all this brush, which right now I'm just going to kind of abbreviate. Little bits of darkness, which I can sort of get in here. Here we have this amazing up cliff. And this is a time where I want to use a little bit more of a sweeping brush stroke to show just this incredible incline here. And then I can take my white, my highlight color here, and actually use it to carve out this rock sort of in reverse and pay a little bit more careful attention to the edges and how they actually fall. Speaking of falling, I don't know what's going on with this lamp. Fan brush now. Just gonna calm some of this down a little bit. Calm a little bit of these brush strokes down. Just very gently, very gently whisking it over.